did you kind of feel it's got the metal, you know, the metal building with the facade, wrapped facade on the front. And I'm in landscaping also, so you know, my mind, we'll build a building and put a 30-gallon trees down the sides and maybe a 10-foot wrap, it's stone with a porch in the front to kind of mimic the attorney's office next door to give it a feel of at least that, you know. And we're doing it, I guess, basically because I think this, the city would be a good place to put a building that does a little bit of business and a little bit of small, maybe shipping and packaging, maybe somebody can sell cars out of the back, or maybe toy cars or something like that, and boxes and things like that. You just never know. But I think, you know, we have a lot of just basic buildings that are rented out, like Mary Alice Park, for instance, and all those basically for small businesses that can run the paperwork, but this will be a little bit of both. And I think it'll look good sitting in that location right there, North Kelly Mill. I think, you know, we'll have the front entrance with the handicap coming up both sides, if we need to do that, and then have the sides will be sodded with sprinkler system. And I think Scott had mentioned to us or someone about putting possibly changing the back for a little bit of buffer on the back for some grass buffer instead of having it connect to the street and have the entrance on both sides of the rear of the property. I think aesthetically it'll look pleasing. You know, we considered putting a more stonework, I guess, all over the building to make it look like it would be okay there. I think if we did a darker color in the particular metal on the sides, and we put the 6 to 7 foot caliper trees down the sides, it'll look pretty nice, you know, if we didn't do a light color. So we're thinking a dark gray family or a dark brown family on the sides, and with stone in front, with columns in the front, with outdoor landscape lighting on the trees and throughout the property. So that's kind of what we're thinking. And each building will be around 2,700, 2,600 square feet for each pod. And the office is about 600 or 700 square feet. The warehouse is about 1,900 to 2,000 square feet, probably, give or take. So that's kind of where we at. We'd like to start on it as soon as we, you know, get approval and have it done maybe before spring.
All right. Thank you.
We may
have questions in a minute. Thank you for
asking. Oh, I stay right here?
No, you can do it.
Okay.
Is everybody here want to speak against this room, or anybody else got anything to say? All right, any questions from the board?
Yes,
okay, do I have a motion to close public hearing?
Motion to close public hearing.
Second.
Motion second by vote. Motion to close. Thank you. All right, so we're going to say after the board,
Yes, sir, do some packets. Review it. I'll be happy to like to read it into the record. The property owner has made application to the proper authorities for a conditional use permit to operate a contractor's establishment within the central business district of the city of Cumming. Property is currently vacant and bounded on the east by a recently constructed office professional, on the west by existing single family residential and institutional to the north. As Mr. Gober said, the building will be divided into four units, each with approximately 770 square feet of office in the front facing Kelly Mill Road and 1,940 square feet warehouse in the rear facing Samaritan, totaling approximately 10,840 square feet. Off-street parking will be provided in front of each office unit and behind the warehouse space with ingress egress from Ambulance Pine and Samaritan Drives. Staff's reviewed this COP application and finds it consistent with the CBD zoning future land use plan designation of the property as public institutional. Staff recommends approval of the COP with the following four conditions. Number one, the building exterior must be brick on all four sides. Number two, the development will include a minimum of 14 9 by 18 perpendicular parking spaces, including two handicap accessible spaces, to be located in front of the building. Minimum of 3 9 by 18 parking spaces will be located behind the building. Condition number three, a rolled curb and gutter will be installed along the entire width of the heavy duty paving at the rear of the property to be approved by the planning and zoning department. And condition number four, the development will include a minimum 15-foot landscape strip in front of the building and 10-foot landscape strips on each side of the building to be approved by the planning and zoning department. be happy to answer any questions you might have on this.
Any questions from the board? I'll make a motion to send conditional use permit number 2017266 forward to the board for approval with the conditions read by Scott in the zoning report, changing condition number 3 to read that a 10-foot minimum landscape strip approved by the planning and zoning department shall be planted along the rear of the property. Can I have a second?
Second.
Motion second, anybody vote? Carries unanimous. Thank you. All right. Item number 5, new business. Georgia Mountain, go give us a report on our Nine Road Board study yesterday. Guys, y'all want to come up and tell us about it?
As you recall, we've been meeting on this during the year, and this is the final report. And one of the things in the report that we do detail is economic development incentives. So the idea is Caleb's got the quarter study here up. I'm going to kind of walk you through the final report first. I told Scott tomorrow we will send electronic versions of the report and of the rendering boards that you're having an electronic version. But I'll walk you through the report, kind of tell you some of our findings, and then Caleb is going to go through. We found 8 focus areas along the Atlanta Highway corridor that we focused on. He's going to walk you through some of the before and afters. Page 3, the project scope, methodology, and focus areas. As you all know, we've been working on this project this past year, looking at this area and trying to figure out what kind of parameters we can do to improve the corridor. One thing we noticed was a number of gaps in sidewalk connectivity. So you'll notice on the rendering board and in your first page of the 11x17, the yellow lines denote sidewalks. So where there are gaps, that's to where there's actually a lack of sidewalks, and typically you'll see paths through the grass and such. We've also highlighted a potential gateway down at the bottom with the 4 circles, kind of as a welcome to Cumming signage that could also promote local events. The purple spots on the map are historic properties, things that you could utilize for either economic development. One of them is number 6. Is actually a restaurant right now currently. We've also highlighted in orange infill and redevelopment opportunities, things that we saw that were vacant. And then of course the blue is the actual overlay corridor. The yellow is the sidewalks. And then the triangles actually point you into the direction that you're looking at that view shed. So we look to see what we can do to improve the corridor to make it more aesthetically pleasing, more safe to walk upon, and just to be a more walkable environment, and then kind of ultimately propel more economic development. Page 4 shows that beginning map to where we looked at the blue outline for the corridor and the signage, the sidewalks. And then pages 5 through 12 really get into some of the conditions that we saw. Just kind of, if you were new to Cumming and you were walking down Atlanta Highway, what would you see? So we did kind of some sample visual images to showcase what you see. Page 13 through 30 is actually, or through 29 is what Caleb's going to talk to you about, those actual focus areas that we looked at, and the actual recommendations we have. And really, you know, we looked at 8 spots, and they touch upon the same things, either redevelopment and kind of updating properties that just need new paint, new either brick or stone veneer, new roofing if they haven't been occupied for a long time. Maybe they need more, again, sidewalks and whatever types of retaining walls that are necessary. And then just street trees and shrubbery, just to make it more pleasing. And that kind of goes into page 30, complete streets policy, which really are those types of things, traffic calming, and how to make your streets a walkable, more pedestrian-friendly environment. So we include that in there kind of as an appendices to, so if somebody's going through this and trying to figure out, well, how could we implement this? That's one aspect. And then showcasing basic policy specifications you have from GDOT on pages 35 and 36, sidewalk sizes, buffers, just a general outline of what you could do. And then page 37, we put in design guidelines. These are just basically sample design guidelines on massing, on materials, on a building shape and facade appearance, the basic things that you already look at when you approve new building and zoning applications. But we have that in there. And then finally, the economic development portion on page 41, we have outlined 6 different programs that could be a benefit for Cumming to help some of this. Obviously, number 1, Chamber of Commerce beautification programs, you could look at creating something or implementing it for that area. SPLOST is a one that happens quite often. Traffic enhancement in GDOT is another one. That one, less so, it seems like GDOT, it takes a while for their project list to come up.
And we're out from under GDOT on this, right?
That's correct.
Well, that is true.
Yeah, there's no longer the Highway 9.
We swapped down for things, so, Memorial.
Right.
Yeah. So we're okay.
Yeah,
that's just not, that's what I thought.
Yeah. Not every one of these is going to apply
for
this.
Right.
That was just trying to find how many we could find. LMIG, and then really the 2 that I always see from our office in economic development, CDGB and ARC. A lot of times that goes into job creation, it goes into kind of the worthiness of each project since it is very competitive. But those are the 2 that we always see when, probably especially CDGB, when people are doing sidewalk and infrastructure improvements. So we have tried to go in and kind of find a starting point for these recommendations. And Caleb is going to walk you through then this board and the following pages.
Thank you.
Some of these you'll recognize from the last time we met with you guys. I'm going to try to walk through them as quickly as I can. But the first before and after you'll see here is the proposed gateway that we have at the intersection of Lynn Highway and Veterans. This would be a good place to kind of welcome newcomers into the city, as well as promote events if you want to put an LED screen or something like that here, or just signage, either one. It'd be a great place for to get a lot of eyes on what's going on in Cumming, or just let them know where they're at. Number 2, we'll go down to the Publix parking lot area, and you'll see it right here on your map. And basically what we did here was propose just a lot of trees, a lot of screenage from the landscaping, just to kind of mask that big parking lot area and kind of soften the feel of that parking lot. So you'll see a lot of the trees have been added inside the parking lot in the different islands, as well as along the street side there as well. Number three.
Kevin, excuse me, just a second on number two. Is there any additional sidewalk in there?
We didn't add sidewalk here because that was kind of a narrow strip along that section.
Yeah, that we as we were going through these, sidewalks is one thing that we tried to add to as much as possible. Number one and number two were instances to where, unless you really kind of change that landscape some, it is more of a challenge, but definitely kind of adding more of these yellow lines, the better.
And it could definitely be done because that is just a parking lot behind there. So if you wanted to do that, you could. It would just take a little work. Number three is from the last time we met, the package store that we kind of retrofitted with some facade upgrades and sidewalk and street trees in front. Number four was our infill that we added to the empty parking lot by the movie theater. We also added sidewalk. Well, the sidewalk was existing. We added street trees to continue that theme down through the corridor. That was one main thing that we tried to do with these eight focus areas, was create continuity throughout the corridor so that it all tied in with each other. Number five is the shopping complex towards the middle of the map. Basically, all we did here was street trees, streetscape upgrades to kind of mask this parking lot area again. Number six would be the abandoned Mr. Swiss building that we kind of retrofitted with a Starbucks or something smaller like that could work well on that corner or lot right here.
That's certainly empty.
We also added a sidewalk connection here because, as you can see in your map, the sidewalk connection kind of slacks off right here on the end. So we connected that and also added some more street trees to continue that theme. Number seven would be the car wash, which we basically just added sidewalk connection to and masked again with street trees. And number eight was from our last meeting where we had this kind of strip mall parking lot that we again masked with street trees and created sort of a retaining wall with a sidewalk connection that would run up to the cemetery.
Did y'all explore, so I think in our last meeting we talked about the sidewalk with trees being on the street side and the sidewalk being in versus the sidewalk being out. And I'm seeing both options here. Did y'all explore that and see if
I believe it's mentioned in the complete streets. Are there some
generally it would be the trees on the roadside and then the sidewalk. So that would be the preferred route.
Yeah.
But then a lot of times with these site constraints it just depends. I mean here we've already got your sidewalks right up there on the roadway.
Mm-hmm.
So and actually the complete streets policy, sometimes they get into what's called a road diet, where you actually take away part of the roadway and either add in brick pavers to kind of thin that road out a bit if it is more of a secondary road now. I mean, there's a lot of options that could be considered. It just depends what's feasible. Sometimes when we're doing this, we look and see even if you could do an island of trees down the middle. It didn't work out so much on this one, again, unless you do a road diet or working on the turn lanes as well. But we looked at a lot of ideas just to see what could work. But generally, this type of idea was the more preferred as much as possible.
Number eight is concerning.
Yeah, seven and eight.
So no middle island anywhere for right now. I mean, I know there's a lot of turns in there. You would
get to where you'd have, I mean, three, four trees, and then you'd have to stop again. So more the idea was for buffers to do it on the sidewalk side.
Right.
on the perimeter.
We're not forwarding this or anything, we're just absorbing it, we got...
We're just absorbing it right now, that's right, that's right.
I don't, I mean, I appreciate this right now, I don't have any questions right this second, because, like I said, let me go with it.
Like I said, tomorrow we're sending Scott the digitals of all of us, and then if you have any questions after that, we'll be glad to, if you see any changes you want us to make, it's not a problem.
Okay. All right.
Well, we probably need to get it, and then we'll all meet at some point.
Exactly, yeah, yeah.
And go over it, I guess.
Okay.
We best, all right.
Anybody have some questions?
Is there anything?
Can...
Thank you, guys, appreciate it.
Thank you.
We'll leave, these copies and boards with you, and then...
Yeah, I was gonna ask you to do that, it'd be great, thank you. Sure, appreciate that.
All right, item number six, we got any announcements?
No, we got a good favor.
Does that have a motion to adjourn?
Motion to adjourn?
Second. Anybody will, lead in adjourn, thanks.
Thank you.
Scott, you wanna leave these, Scott, you wanna leave these boards out here?
I'll take them, thank you very much, Kelly. Get you the complete staff planning commission recommendations for next meeting, and then if we need to, we can, you know, we can talk about that. I appreciate you getting Brian to do that site plan, because that was a lot better for them to work off of. And I knew you'd have to do it at some point anyway.
He looked really good. I was impressed.
Yeah, he did a really good job with it, and he knows, of course, he did the attorney's office right across the street, yeah. So he's familiar with the area, and he even answered some questions that we had. We've got sewer line running through there.
I made it on four sides, I think, basically, too.
So yeah, so.
You figured out which one to grow and grab.
Exactly, yep. So it worked out really well.
And that was good, I'm glad it worked out. So.
What I'll do, like I said, I will get y'all a copy of that amended staff report, and then once you do that, then we can, I'll just give
okay,
you
thank
just
you.
You have it, yeah. And then once I get that to you, then we can talk about that and see. Generally, city council usually follows their recommendations on it, so that's
yeah.
Pretty much, you know, unless they want to maybe change or add something, but they definitely.
Well, is that Dudger too? The same?
It'll be the same meeting. It'll be that Thursday, Tuesday in November, but it'll be at 6 o'clock.
Okay.
That's when the council usually meets,
okay.
Right here, and they usually will have a, you know, there'll be our planning commission meetings usually fairly quick, but those last a little longer, but because there's several more items on the agenda. But usually planning and zoning is up pretty quick in the meeting, so.
And after that point, then if everything goes kosher, then we're.
Then you're good to go.
Green light.
Yeah, yeah, absolutely.
Thank you so much.
Yes, sir. Nice to meet you.
Appreciate your help a lot.
Our pleasure, our pleasure. I'll send that to you. I'll get that to you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm.